Now let's take a look at how to insert tables into your page content. This button is the Insert Edit Table button, and so when you want to put a table into your content, you put your cursor where the table will be inserted and you click this button. And you can configure the settings for the table that you'll insert. So I'll make one that's 4 columns by 4 rows, and I'll make it 100% wide. I'm going to leave cell padding and cell spacing blank because the style sheet of my website will control the spacing of the table cells and the other styles that determine what it looks like. The border is set to 0, and that's fine. You'll still be able to see the edges of the cells in the editor here, even though that's set to 0. And then I'm going to give my table a caption. This is the header that's attached to the table that defines or determines or explains what the table is about. So I'll click Insert, and now I have a blank table. And this row up here is the table caption. So I will begin by putting some content in there, and then I can begin filling in the cells of my table. Now I've already got a complete table in my clipboard, so I'm just going to paste that in there to save some time. So here's my table, and currently all of the cells have the same meaning. They're just data cells, and then we have the caption. When you're thinking about inserting a table or creating a table in your content, it's a good idea to think about what the columns and column headers should be, and then actually mark them as headers. So these 4 columns each have a header that need to be designated as table headers. So to do that, we just click our cursor right into the cell, and this button is the table cell properties button. We can click that and change the cell type from data to header, and then just define the scope as the column. So this particular header that we're defining right here is the header for this column. So the scope is the column. And then I'm going to choose update all cells in the row so that all of those top cells will become headers for their columns. And click update, and now those are headers. And these 3 cells here are also headers, but they are headers for their row. So we can go into each one and change it to a header and set the scope as the row. Now you'll have noticed when I did the top one and I chose update every cell in the row, I could have chosen update every cell in the column. I am not choosing that right now because I don't want to change the top one into the same definition as the one I'm currently working on. So I don't want to actually choose this, but you can if you have a table that this would make the definition for all of the ones in the column the same. Got one more. So now we have our caption and our headers and then our regular data. So I'll just save my progress here. And now if I wanted to add another row in between a couple of these, I could put my cursor into the row, and depending upon where I want to put the new row, I can choose insert row before or insert row after. And if I want to add another row to the bottom of the table, then I would put my cursor in the last row and then choose insert row after. and that's how you can add another row. You can do the same with a column. You can add a column by clicking the Insert Column Before or After button next to whichever column you have your cursor in. And you can also remove rows by putting your cursor in the row that you want to remove and removing it with this Delete Row button. And you can do the same with a column by hitting the Delete Column button. Another thing you can do is select two cells and merge them together. So this is the Merge Table Cells button, and you can see that it has combined the content of those two. So we'll just fix that. And then we can change the alignment of the text in any cell by putting our cursor into the cell and choosing again the Table Cell Properties button and setting the vertical alignment to the top. We could also center it if we wanted to. And so now it's at the top and it's basically designating both of these rows. And then if we needed to, we could also split combined cells apart. So we have our cursor in that cell and we have the Split Merge Table Cells button, and it'll split them back apart again, and we can put our content in like that. Now, it's easy to get text down below a table because you can just click below and the cursor is there, and we can put some new content. But to get it above, if you select the table and hit return, you can see that it's hard to get the content above the table. So this is where we can go into the HTML code and insert some space here so that we have somewhere to type if we need to put something above the table. So we click the HTML button, and this code doesn't need to be intimidating if you understand what it's telling you. So the way that HTML works is it will wrap text like this about fruit in these tags that say what it is. So this is the caption, and you can see that there's a beginning tag and an ending tag, and ending tags always have the same name as the beginning but with a slash in the front. And then this is where the table begins, and down here is where the table ends. So we're just looking for the beginning of our table in this case, and we'll just put a return here, and on that first line we can type a paragraph tag, which is a P inside those little brackets. And we can type some content, and then we can just end our P tag like that and click update. And so now we have content above the table that's easy to get at. Another way to avoid having to do that would be to put your content in first, then insert your table. So either way, there is a way to get content above the table. Depending upon the kind of content that you are displaying in your table and the kind of formatting that you have created, you may find that it makes sense to copy a table you've already formatted and then type new content into it. So the easiest way to do that is to just select the table like this and copy, and then I'll put a return here and paste it, and there's my second table. And so I can begin over typing the content with what I want this table to be about, just like that. So let's go ahead and save and publish and take a look at it in preview mode. And so, as you can see, my style sheet is determining the spacing and colors of the captions and the headers and the space between these tables and the content and everything, so it looks nice.